welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Sher Butt, the CEO of CB Therapeutics. And Sher, it's great to see you. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having me on the show, Steve.
Awesome. Lots to talk about with the company and what you're doing, the work that you're doing. But before we get into sort of the nuts and bolts of it, maybe give us a bit of insight into CB Therapeutics, what it's all about.
Sure. So CB Therapeutics is a biotech company here in Southern California in Carlsbad. We started the company in 2016. Initially, we started working on biosynthetic cannabinoids in yeast. So essentially, we're a biotech or a synthetic biology company where we have a platform. We have a multi-million dollar 7,000 square foot facility, which includes R&D and manufacturing space as well. And we are one of the first companies to have created CBD and 13 other cannabinoids in yeast. That was our earlier work in 2016. We're currently commercializing it to a much larger scale for production and sales in the next few months for different types of cannabinoids. And we're also the first private company in the world to make psilocybin and seven of the other analogs in mushrooms in yeast as well. And also the first company as of yesterday to make DMT and some of its analogs in yeast as well. So in essence, the one sentence that would describe the company is we are the largest portfolio holder of natural molecules and medicines that are reverse engineered in yeast.
Yeah. Explain sort of the synthetic side of it, because I think people might not understand what that means. So explain to us what you mean when you say synthetic.
Great. Yeah. So typically, biosynthetic and synthetic is two different terms. And just to go over understanding a little bit, synthetic usually refers to chemical synthesis. And one of the problems we have with synthetic molecules that are made with chemical synthesis is they're hard to purify, and you get different types of molecules. So to give you an example, you have your left hand and you have your right hand, but they look similar, but you can't fit a right hand glove on a left hand, right? Because in 3D, they're different. So chemical synthesis often leads to molecules that are not exactly identical. We use a method called biosynthesis, which is different from chemical synthesis. What we do is we take the machinery out of the plant or the fungus. So for example, for psilocybin, we've taken the enzymes and the machinery and the genes that are found in the mushroom, and we've put them inside yeast, and we've engineered the yeast cell to, when it eats sugar, instead of making alcohol, it makes psilocybin or any other molecule.
Let's talk about psilocybin, because I'm hearing a lot about that in the last little while, especially with the concern about opioid overdoses and the crisis that's going on around the world with that. Sure. What do you think is the benefits of psilocybins, and then what you're doing as well in order to try and battle something like an opioid crisis?
Sure. So I mean, you know, I'm not a doctor, so obviously I can't give out medical advice, but what I can say is there's a lot of trials out there that show very positive results for psilocybin for treatment-resistant depression. Certainly, companies like Compass Pathways are leading the way in this space. There is also a lot of potential that I see with not just natural psilocybin, the way that it is extracted from the mushroom, but also analog molecules. So molecules of psilocybin, for example, that are slightly altered in a way that gives it slightly different properties. So for example, we would be able to take out or reduce the trip time from, let's say, 4 to 5 hours to down to 30 minutes. So those are the types of things that we're working on. In terms of how effective all these molecules are going to be, we just signed a partnership for collaboration with the Cleveland Clinic a month and a half ago. So what we will be doing is we'll be producing many new types of variants of psilocybin and other molecules, and we'll be collaborating with Cleveland Clinic to see what those effects are. And the goal is to get some of these molecules to FDA after clinical trials into FDA approval.
And what's sort of the revenue model for the company? How would you sort of take the technology that you have and the work that you're doing in order to monetize that?
Yeah, so we're monetizing the tech in a couple different ways. On the cannabinoid side, we're not going with the FDA route. We're only dealing with non-psychoactive cannabinoids like CBD, CBG, THCV. And because of that, we will be just selling the cannabinoids to wholesalers and other companies that want to infuse it into their products. So in fact, in 2 months, we're starting our first sales. We're shipping product out on that side. So that's going to be a revenue generating event starting in 2 to 3 months from now. On the tryptamines and some of the other molecules, I think there needs to be a lot more responsibility because of the potential of misuse of these molecules. So for those types of molecules, we will exclusively be going the clinical trials in the FDA path. So in the short term, we're going to be generating revenue from the cannabinoids themselves, some variants of cannabinoids, and any custom molecules that anybody wants to make. And in the long term, we are looking at FDA approved medicines with psilocybin, its variants, and also the newly molecule, we made DMT.
And last question, you mentioned your work with Cleveland Clinic. Is that something you see more yourself doing more of, is partnerships with certain people and certain ways of trying to find uses for the stuff that you're creating?
Absolutely. I think there's a treasure trove of molecules. And I think what this tells us in these trials and what's going on tells us that there's so much that we don't know. And I think one of the beauties of what we do as a company is our yeast platform allows us to, let's say, today make cannabinoids, tomorrow we can make psilocybin. So we're always looking for new variants and things. And to answer your question, yes, I think the way forward is through clinical trials and heavy scrutiny using science to go through all these molecules, these claims that people make. And that, I think, will lead to something very beneficial for mankind in general.
Wow. Super fascinating. It's amazing how quickly we've come in a couple of years of legalization, for sure. Sher, great to see you. Thanks very much for the info on the company, and hope to talk again real soon.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Steve, for having me. Take care.
All right. Sher Butt, the CEO of CB Therapeutics.